Hello students, my name is Anthony sir and today we are going to learn the second lesson of class 7 and we have in our previous videos we have finished lesson number 1 and poem number 1. So in this video we will learn lesson number 2 and then in our next video we will learn poem number 2. But this lesson is also very long and it is in two parts, so we will have part 1 video and part 2 video. Okay, the name of this lesson is The Gift of Chappals, and we all know chappals that we are wearing. Okay, and here chappals are given as a gift. Okay, that is the meaning of the title. But in this lesson we will see culture of South India, because here the place described, it is Madras, which is now called Chennai, and some South Indian names also that we have to learn in this lesson. Let's see what is in the background of the lesson. Okay, I read and I will explain. Before you read, Mridu is a young girl growing up in Madras. Now remember, when I read, you must also have your textbook so that you can see in the textbook, and if I give any meanings, you should write it down. Okay, so Mridu is a young girl from where? Madras. But Madras, which is also called Chennai, with Tappi. Tappi, it is of course Tamil word which means grandmother, and Tatha is a Tatha. Okay, which means grandfather. One afternoon, Tappi takes her to her aunt Rukumani's house. So her auntie's name is what? Rukumani. Okay, so Rukumani's house to meet her cousins. And who are the cousin of Mridu? Lali, Ravi and Meena. These are very particular names, which are very common names that we find in India. Okay, now I start part 1 lesson. A smiling Rukumani threw open the door. Rukumani is her auntie, so she opened the door. Ravi and Meena, who are the cousin of Mridu, rushed out, and Ravi pulled Mridu into the house. Okay, now they went out and they brought Mridu, pulled her into the house. It's like a guest who has come. So they invited her inside the house by pulling. Wait, let me take off my slippers. She said, let me remove my slippers, protested Mridu. Mridu said that, just wait, let me remove my shoes. Protest means to stop somebody. She set them out neatly near a pair of a large black ones. Okay, so she put the shoes near another black pair of shoes which was there. Those were grey actually with dust. Now the description of the slippers. Okay, it was actually grey color and full of dust. You could see the clear mark of every toe on the front part of each slipper. It means when you use the slipper for long time, you can see the part, the mark of your fingers on it, and the toe also. Okay, this marks for the two big toes were long and scrawny. Now the toe mark on the slipper, it was very long also and scrawny. Scrawny means very thin. The meaning is given here. Mridu did not have much time to wonder about whose slipper they were. She did not have that much time to think about whose slipper is this, because Ravi dragged her to the background. Because Ravi dragged her. Drag means to pull to her in the backyard. Backyard is the backside area of the house. Behind a thick bitter berry bush. Okay, there was a bush. Bush means a place where there are plants and other things, like a kind of garden. Okay, but here it is bitter berry bush. It means berry means fruits, and bitter, they were very bitter, which you cannot eat. Okay, there inside a torn football, there was a football which was actually torn, it was of no use, lined with sucking and filled with sand. It was lying there full of sucking. And it was also filled with sand. There was a sand on it. Normally when something is lying there for so long time, you can see some dust and sand on it. Lay a very small kitten. Kitten is the baby of cat. So there was a small kitten lying on that in that football. Lapping up milk from a coconut half shell. Okay, there was a coconut shell and in that there was a milk. So she was lapping. Lapping up means to drink. So she was drinking the milk. We found him outside the gate this morning. He was mewing and mewing. Mewing means making the sound. Poor thing, said who? Said Meena. Now when Meena saw the cat, you can see it in the picture how she is lying under under that there is a football which was torn, and from coconut shell she is drinking the milk and making noise. Now Meena, it's a secret. It means we are not going to tell anybody about this cat. Amma says Patti will leave for our Paddu Mama's house if she knows we have a cat. It means Patti, it means grandmother, she doesn't like to have a cat in the house. That is why we are not going to tell anybody about this cat. Okay? People are always telling us to be kind to animals. Now they are talking among themselves, these cousins, the small children, they are talking among themselves. So people are always telling them to be kind to other animals. But when we are kind, they start screaming. Oh, don't bring that dirty creature here. This is a kind of shouting that you get in the house. Okay, said Ravi. Do you know how hard it is to get a little milk from the kitchen? Now, because they have kitten, they have to feed the kitten also. And it was very difficult for them to get the milk from the kitchen because nobody knew that there is a cat. And every time they have to tell lie to bring the milk to the cat. Now Patti saw me with a glass in my hand just now. And what was in the glass? Milk. Patti means grandma saw her. So I told her I'm very hungry. So I told grandma that I'm very very hungry. I want to drink it. But the way she looked at me, I had to drink most of it. Okay. So she was telling lie that she wants to drink the milk. But grandma looked at her with angry face, and because she was angry, she had to drink that milk, almost more than half. Okay, good. I had to drink most of it to throw her off the scent. What is the meaning of throw her off the scent? Means to mislead her, to misguide her from that situation. Okay, then she wanted the tumbler back. Tumbler back means is the glass. Okay, the normally the plastic glass, we call it tumbler. Patti, I will wash it myself. She was telling grandma that, grandma, don't worry, I will wash it myself. Why should I put you in trouble? Okay, I don't want to give you trouble. I told her I had to run and pour the milk into the coconut shell and then run back and wash the tumbler and put it back before she got really suspicious. So after saying that, quickly she rushed to the kitchen and she poured the little milk that was remaining in the coconut shell, and then again she rushed into the kitchen to wash the tumbler, the glass, okay, before grandma becomes suspicious that what they are doing. Now we have to think of some other way to feed Mahendran. Okay, Mahendran is the name of the cat. So they were thinking of different options how they are going to feed the cat. Mahendra, this little kitty's name is Mahendra. Mridu was impressed. Now Mridu, remember that she is a guest and she has come in this house. Okay, so she was very impressed with the name Mahendran. It was a real name, because normally we don't give this kind of name to the cat, not just like a cute kitty cat name. Okay, so it was not like a cat name, but it was like a real name of a person. Actually his name is Mahendra Verma Pallava Punai. This is the long name given to the cat, MP Punai, for short if you like. So the full name of the cat is Mahendra Verma Pallava Punai, and in short it is called MP Punai. He is a fine breed of cat. Breed means type of cat. Okay, now normally we have different breed in dogs that we keep it in our house. Okay, so cat also has different breed, different types. Just look at his fur. Fur means the hair on its body. like a lion's mane. It looks like a lion's face. Okay. And you know what the emblem of the ancient Pallava kings was? And she was saying, emblem here means symbol. Do you know what was the symbol of Pallava kings? Don't you? He looked expectantly at Mridu. So they were asking this question to Mridu, but Mridu didn't know the answer. So that is why Mridu giggled. Giggle means laugh. Think I am joking? Well, just wait. So now Mina and her brother, they are saying, we are not joking, just wait. I will show you something. It's clear you don't know a thing about history. So now they are telling Mridu that you don't know many things about history. That is why you are laughing on MP Punai. Haven't been to Mahabalipuram? Then they asked her, have you been to Mahabalipuram? Mahabalipuram is the name of the place. He said mysteriously. Mysteriously means trying to know something which is hidden. That is called mysteriously. Well, when our class went to Mahabalipuram, this is Meena who is talking. Mahabalipuram, I saw a statue of his tatas, etc., etc. It means grandfathers, etc. So that is the long time back. Fact is, Mahendran here is a descendant from that very same ancient cat. It means there was a statue of cat, idol of cat, and that cat was a it belongs to the god because it is in the temple. And these people, these children, they are saying that Mahendran is the descendant. Descendant means it has came in the same line of this family cat. A close relative, scientifically speaking, of none other than the lion. Okay, so this cat is very close relative of that cat which is in Mahabalipuram, and according to science we can say that they are this cat is none other than the lion. It looks like lion, the Pallava lion, and they are called Pallava lion. Pallava is the name of the king, family is the dynasty. Okay, emblem of Pallava's dynasty. What was the emblem? Emblem means symbol. Symbol of Pallava dynasty was a cat, okay, which looks like lion. Ravi went on walking around the bitter berry bush, waving a twig up and down. Twig means branch of the tree, up and down, so that he can catch the attention of the cat. His eyes sparkling, okay, his eyes were sparkling, shining. This cat is a descendant of none other than the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. So they were saying that this cat is actually is from that family which is in Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And if I may just remind you, they worship cat in ancient Egypt also. Now the second story is that the people in Egypt in ancient time, they used to worship cat also. Okay, next page. How he loved the sound of his own voice. Okay, cat really liked the sound of his own voice. Meena and Mridu exchange looks means they were watching each other. What does that have to do with anything? Mridu demanded. Mridu asked. It means what is that? What is the meaning of that? Huh? I'm telling you that this cat is descended from the Egyptian cat. Now another story that has come, that this cat is the descendant. It has come from the ancient cat god from Egypt. No goddess. Bastet. Yeah, that's it. It means he was saying god. Then he remembered that no, is a female cat. So goddess. Okay. So, well, one of the descendant of that cat goddess was Stowaway in one of the Pallava sheep. Another story that has come, that one of the cat god from Egypt, it was stolen and it was kept in Stowaway. Stowaway means someone who hides himself or herself in a ship, okay, or in an aircraft travel during the notice. It means while traveling, when you are hiding in the ship or you are hiding in the plane, that is called Stowaway. So this cat was hiding in the ship when Pallava king was coming from Egypt. And his descendant was Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. So from that Egyptian cat, what came? The ancient Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And from that Rishi cat, we have this cat that we have found in the backyard of our house. That is the full story that they have made. Whose descendant is Ravi flourished his twigs at Mahendra. Now Ravi has moved the twig branches of the tree towards the cat. Cat name is Mahendran. MP Punai here. Whoop, ik, they are making sound so that they can catch the attention. He shriek, very pleased with him. Shriek means making a sound, and he was very happy with the cat. Mahendran looked up, alarmed. Alarm means with very attentive, with very alarmed eyes. He had just been sharpening his claw. Claw means the jaw. He was sharpening the claw on the edge of the coconut shell. With the coconut shell, he was sharpening all the nails. Okay, that is called claw. But worse than Ravi's awful oop ik was a creech. Creech is the sound. Okay, it was a worse sound that came from Mahendram from the window with a weird sound. So another sound that has come from the window, which was very weird. Weird means not familiar, not good sound. If Mridu was startled, strange, yes, another meaning is strange. If Mridu was startled, MP Punai was frightened out of his wit. Wit means laughing. Because Mridu was laughing, MP Punai was also afraid because of Mridu's laugh. Hair standing on end, he bounced up and scurried towards a bamboo tray of red chilies that had been set out to dry. Okay, normally now in the village, normally they do it, they dry red chilies on the terrace. So there was on the terrace, red chilies were drying up there, and this cat who was frightened because Mridu was laughing, a cat jumped on those red chilies, okay, and all the chilies fell down, trying to hide beneath it. Now the cat wanted to hide behind, under the those chili plate or tray. Okay. He tipped a few chilies over himself. Now the problem is some few chilies fell on him, and then he shouted meow meow. He howled miserably because chili is very very hot, and it was actually disturbing Mahendran. Okay, the creaking went on and on. The sound went on and on. The sound was coming again and again. What's that noise? Said Mridu. Mridu asked, what is that noise? That's Lali learning to play the violin. Now the problem is that the sound was the sound of violin that was being played inside the house, played by Lali, grunted Ravi. Ravi shouted, okay, she will never learn a thing. Now they are discussing that, but Lali will never learn a thing because she is always making creak sound. It's very weird sound that pains your ear. The music master just goes on playing like a train whistling on and on. And the music master, he's just playing his music just like a train making a sound, while Lali is all the time derailing. Derailing means Lali is never catching the sound. Railing means to go on the track, and derailing means to go off the track. So Lali was never able to play on the track. She was always off the track, going completely off the track. Okay, next. Okay, yeah, I think it is enough for today, and this is part one. Okay, in part one we must know that Mridu with his grandmother has come to her auntie's house, and her cousins who are there, they are playing there in their background, and in the backyard they have found a cat, and they have made a different story about the cat, that the cat is from Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. It is from Pallava dynasty's symbol, and or some people also say that it is the cat from Egypt, and Egypt god cat. Okay, so all those story that they have made, and it was very difficult to bring the milk for them, but milk for Mahendran, but somehow they were able to manage it, and they were trying to play with the cat, and some creech sound that has come from inside the house, and that was Lali who was playing, and Lali who is never able to play the violin. Okay, so this is the summary of the lesson, and if you have any question you can ask me. In our next video, we will learn part 2. Thank you.